Hi, I'm Mark Tuart with Tuart's Tidbits, and I want to talk to my automotive salespeople and managers out there about how to handle your first objection from a customer. And this is really true of any industry, but the reality is most salespeople, when they hear an objection, they immediately try to handle the objection. And what you're doing is discounting what that customer said, and you're going to make it even harder to get past that objection. You need to back up first by saying, I understand, I appreciate that, sure you bet, I know what you're saying, I feel what you're saying, whatever it is that acknowledges that customer first. You're listening and understanding. Now, secondly, I want you to verify and validate why you proposed what you did. In other words, if it's a price or a payment or anything else, you have to explain why you gave the customer what you did. Example, if it's a price on a vehicle, you have to say, Mr. Customer, all of these vehicles are value priced from the manufacturer. There's not anywhere near the markup there used to be in a vehicle of what there was once upon a time. And that's because of value pricing. That eliminates the back and forth, and it establishes a true market value from the very beginning that keeps us from having to do the unpleasurable of that back and forth. You don't like it, I don't like it, nobody likes it. That's why this is value priced, Mr. Customer. And this particular vehicle was configured in a way that you have a $1,500 option discount package. And then you begin to acknowledge and accept and close. Now, that customer may not still agree with that price, but you have to explain whether it's price, trade, down payments, or monthly payments, how you verify and validate what you gave first. Never start to concede, or worse yet, the worst thing I see salespeople do is to say, Mr. Customer, what were you thinking? What you did is you asked the customer to hit you at a figure that they want that's gonna be probably intolerable, that can't be done, or you're putting them in a position where they now have to almost admit that they were not telling you the truth to do business. You don't wanna do that. Verify and validate. I'm Mark Tuart with Tuart's Tidbits. Check out my website at tuart.com. You can call me anytime you wish at 888-2-TUART. Follow me on Twitter at Mark Tuart as well, and have a great day.